I've been following what is happening in the alliance. Before we talk, I want to ask Chishimba Kamburi some questions. I know that he's watching this broadcast right now. I want to ask him a question before we proceed. In the first place, the battle is not about, it's not a personal battle. The battle that we all have entered into in Zambia is a battle to liberate the people of Zambia. It's not a battle to enrich ourselves. We don't talk about riches. If you are talking about riches, we have it. And we are not selfish about it. We cannot continue being rich and rich and rich and rich. At the end of the day, where is he going to take us? The battle that we are having in Zambia today is a battle of selflessness. It's a battle of people that want to lay down their life. Even the Bible said it. There is no greater love than this, that a man lay down his life for the sake of his friends. It's a battle to liberate the people of Zambia. And Honorable Chishimba Kamburi is aware of this. He knows that it's a battle to liberate the people of Zambia. And what I am seeing now, what I'm hearing now, is no longer what is supposed to be done. I said I'm going to address Akainde Chilemande Chishimba Kamburi, but let me start with Honorable Chishimba Kamburi. I can see that there is a lot of things that are not adding up in the life of Chishimba Kamburi and whatever that is happening. I'm not accusing him. I respect him a lot, like I respect any other person. But I want him to answer these few questions and clear the people of Zambia. There are over 8,000 people that are watching now. It's going to hit 10,000 any moment from now. A lot of people are watching from Zambia. I want to ask Chishimba a question that I would love him to give me the answer. I know PF arrested Chishimba Kamburi because he forged a signature within his family business. He forged a signature of his son, and he was arrested and he was convicted for such a small case. Is it possible, Chishimba Kamburi, that there is a case that is going on where over $160,000 was stolen from your house? From your house. And PF, they have heard about it. The police have heard about it. Kangaja have heard about it. And you have not been arrested for money laundering. Is it possible if you are not very close to PF? I'm not saying that you are close to PF. I don't want to call you Judas. I don't want to talk about you. If I talk about you, table will shake. I don't want to talk about you. I'm asking you a question. Is it possible that you cannot be arrested for having such an amount in your house if you are not close to PF? I want you to stand up and tell the people of Zambia the truth. Are you eating with the PF and eating with the people of Zambia? Or are you with the people of Zambia against PF? Truly speaking, if you are with the people of Zambia, by now they have arrested you. They arrested you for no case. Why are they not arresting you for having over $160,000 in your house? I'm told your daughter stole the money from your house and the others. $160,000. And according to the law of Zambia, because I've been there, studied the law, it's money laundering. Why are they not arresting you for money laundering? You must answer these questions. Let me tell you, people of Zambia, I am CR1. I am ahead of time. I have already, when we are in 2020, I came to 2021 and told you that Chishimba Kamburi is going to be arrested. And the reason why they want to arrest him is because they don't want him to stand as a president, and they don't want Chishimba Kamburi, they don't want him to stand as a running mate. They are going to arrest him and they are going to convict him. I told the people of Zambia openly, exactly do what I told you. Didn't it happen? It happened. The question I'm asking this night is that, Chishimba Kambwiri, did you remember how Dora Silia insulted you in PF? Did you remember how after you campaign, you single-handedly campaigned for Edgar Lungu in 2016, did you remember how he kicked you out from the party? He treated you like a piece of shit. He treated you like a used tissue. He pushed you away. Did you still remember that? Chishimba Kambwiri, if you are not aware, I know that you were in prison by then. PF government with their police stripped your wife and your daughter naked at the court. Are these the people that you want to go back and start eating with? In Nigeria, there is a parable that says, if you have been beaten by a bee before, when you hear the sound of fly, you run away because you don't want to be beaten twice. There is nothing good about PF government. PF government is a rotten government. It's a useless government. It's a satanic government. Are these the people that you want to go back and start eating with? I am asking you a question, Chishimba Kambwiri. I don't want to talk about you. I don't want to go deeper. I just want you to answer these questions. Edgar Lungu used you like a chola boy and threw you away like a fool. Is it the person you want to go and start eating with again, Chishimba Kambwiri? This is the question that I'm asking you. Somebody say, Papa, the video is shaking. I'm sorry because I'm holding it in my hand. I like holding video, holding it in my hand so that you know that it's real. Chishimba Kambwiri, what do you want to do with PF? Let me assure you that I already knew ahead of time that you are going to be brought down. You are going to be shaken and compromised by the PF. And I have always encouraged you not to shake. There is nothing good about PF. PF has already lost the election. I am coming to talk about this. I'm going to give you proof. If you are watching me right now, anywhere you are watching me from, you are watching me right now. I don't know where you are watching me from. Maybe you are watching me from Zambia. You are watching me from Nigeria, from Cameroon. From I don't know where you are watching me from. Everything that I said about Zambia and Zambia election, all of them, tell me which of them that did not happen. I told you in the first place that the way Edgar Lungu and PF is planning to rig the election, I was already in the system. Before I came out from Zambia, before I was deported from Zambia, I was already in the system. I was there. I know everything about the system. Plus the help of Godfather. There is nothing hidden. Everything I told you that they are going to register a lot of people in their stronghold. They are going to give opposition stronghold manufactured machine. They are going to give a lot of excuses so that they will register a lot of people in their stronghold thinking that they have won the election. Registering 1 million people from your stronghold does not mean they are going to vote. There is a plan that I'm going to review to UPND. This election has already been done and UPND has won the election. I'm going to tell them how to protect their vote. If Edgar Lungu does not leave power this coming August, they know that I'm stupid. I said it. If Edgar Lungu wins this election, I will drop the microphone. I will stop being a prophet. I know everything I've told you from A to Z. And I told you that they are going to convict Chishimba Kambwiri. If Chishimba Kambwiri is a wise man, he will have nothing to do with PF. My father gave birth to me and said, your name is Ezia, meaning good name. It's better to have good name than to have money. If you have money, you don't have good name, you are a fool.
If you have money, if you have power, look at GBM. GBM is now a fool. He has money, he has everything, but he's a fool. He doesn't have name. He's now a chola boy for Edgar Lungu. Edgar was a baby boy. Edgar was nothing when GBM was a deputy, a defense minister. Today, GBM has been reduced from a minister to a campaign manager, and he's running up and down like chicken campaigning for Edgar Lungu. For what reason? Who is Edgar Lungu? What is Edgar Lungu? Chishimbakambri, I'm asking you this question. Answer me this question. I don't want you to come to people of Zambia and pretend like HH is doing this, UPN is doing this, my secretary general is doing this, this and that. No, I want you to answer these questions before you start putting blames. When I finish talking to you, I will come to HH. Why are you not arrested for keeping over $160,000 in your house? If you are not in good books with PF, PF can arrest an opposition leader for coughing. You can be arrested. How much more when there is a crime? Why have they not arrested you? It means, I'm not saying that it has happened. It means that somewhere, somehow, you have started eating with them. Because if you eat with them, you can commit any crime you want. You cannot be arrested. This is the question that I'm asking you, Honorable Chishimbakambwe. Answer me this question. Why have you not been arrested? Why? Answer the people of Zambia this question. Let me tell you, people of Zambia, let me share something with you. Before Sata became a president, there was an opposition alliance. Towards the election, few weeks before the election, opposition alliance got destroyed. People said, oh my God, it's over for us. Oh my God, we have lost the election. I said to PF then and to SATA, listen, go ahead. When it's your time, with or without alliance, it is your time. And SATA went and won the election without an alliance. By then, everything was still okay in Zambia. The biggest crime that MMD committed by then was the little corruption, selling of Zamtel, buying of a lot of bicycle, little corruption. But Kwacha was doing well, the economy was doing well, but still, without an alliance, SATA defeated Rupiah Banda. Today, Kwacha has lost value. The reason why it pains me so much is because I have to say this to you today. Go to PACRO and discover that I still have businesses that are running in Zambia. Businesses have been affected because Kwacha has lost value. Kwacha is now useless. The Kwacha that we are bragging about is now one of the worst performing currencies in Zambia. Corruption has climbed. How much is a bag of mealy meal in Zambia today? How much is a bottle of cooking oil in Zambia today? How many people are able to export and import in Zambia today? You can see that everyone wants change. People are no longer talking. Everybody is quiet. What they are going to do is in their mind. Those of you that are jumping up and down, PF will win. PF have registered much number in their opposition. Did you see the local government election that took place a few weeks ago? In the stronghold of PF, PF won it with only but, it's not even 50%, with a little margin in their stronghold. On the day of general election, PF is going to be shocked. In Luapula, they are going to be shocked. In the eastern part of the nation, they are going to be shocked. All those places that they have rigged already, saying we have registered million, we have registered this, we have registered that. All those places, they are going to be shocked. UPND is going to win elections. Listen to me very, very carefully. I am not an ordinary prophet. I am Siyawan Jagaban. I live ahead of time. Everything I told you, they have come to pass. What is going to fail? Is it just one election that is coming that I've told you that UPND has won? People of Zambia, hold your peace. Hold your peace. Hold your peace. Your liberation is coming. You are about to be delivered from the hand of criminals, from the hands of fools, from the hands of thugs. Many of you in Zambia now are living in fear. You are living in fear. You are afraid. You cannot even talk in public. If you talk, cadres will beat you up. Cadres are becoming millionaires, building houses. People that are educated are suffering in Zambia. Hold your peace. Your time of liberation is coming. Your time of liberation is on the way. I'm telling you that you will not be disappointed. Prepare yourself. There are many things that I don't want to reveal. The reason why I kept quiet a bit is because there are a lot of things that I was working on. Your vote is going to be protected. That day on the election, you are going to see what is going to happen. Kaiser Zulu is going to be silenced. All the rigging machine of PF are going to be caught and silenced. I don't want to talk about the plan. Let it be. But I want you to know that day, go and vote. Your vote is going to be protected. I know what I'm talking about. Chishimba Kambwiri. I am telling you, my brother, if you have decided to go into marriage with PF, you want to bring down heaven on earth. Those are corrupt people. Light and darkness has nothing in common to share. They are criminals. They are thieves. The people that are supposed to enjoy PF are slave queens, prostitutes. Those people that are joining PF, those that are sleeping with the minister, PF is a Sodom and Gomorrah of modern era. It's a place where you have to survive with your private part. It's a place where slave queens are becoming richer than educated people. If you are wise, you have nothing to do with PF. You have no place in PF. The only people that succeed in PF are criminals. Are these the people that you want to join, Chishimba Kambwiri? If you don't want alliance, if you don't want anything to do with alliance, sit down in your house. Have nothing to do with PF. PF is a rotten party led by a rotten human being, a drunkard, Eddie Galungu. Edgar Lungu did not change and he will not change. Edgar Lungu is a drunkard. Edgar Lungu, he stole money from his client when he was a lawyer. A poor lawyer who tell you that he's not going to steal when he becomes a president. That is why he has destroyed the economy completely, because of stealing. Rampant stealing. Rampant looting. Edgar Lungu cannot change. A lizard on earth can never be a crocodile in heaven. If you are a thief, you are a thief. You cannot beat around the bush. If you are a criminal, you are a criminal. If you are a drunkard, you are a drunkard. If you are a womanizer, you are a womanizer. There is nothing you can do about it. Be very careful, Chishimba Kambwiri. Don't join rotten people. Remember what Dorasilia did to you. Remember what Jean Kapata did to you. Be a man that have two balls. Don't start clapping front and clap behind. I'm coming to you, Akainde Echilem. My dear brother, let me tell you something about African politics. You don't understand African politics, my dear Echilem. You are doing politics like you are in America. You are too holy. You are too gentle. Such politics does not exist in Africa. The politics of Africa is fire for fire. I wish I can talk to you and tell you how to do politics in Africa. There is nothing like relaxing in Africa. You can study the history of SATA and look at how SATA won election. You can study it. You are too gentle. You are too holy. And change. It is time now to go fire for fire. It's better to be arrested than to have your victory stolen. I'm not going to allow your victory to be stolen again. I am here, but you must wake up and fight. It is iron to iron. It is fire to fire. I also congratulated UPND through my post on Facebook for the successful conference that you did. Everyone can see that we have something to learn from them. But let me tell you, the people of UPND, Hakainde Hichilema, all the leaders of UPND, this time around, it's not about you. It's about the presidency. It's not about you going into parliament. I said it before. There is nothing that you are going to do with parliament seat again. It's all about getting to state house. You cannot change Zambia. You cannot deliver Zambia from thieves by going to parliament. Your campaign must be about the presidency. Your campaign, those of you that are campaigning, you want to stand as MP. You want to stand as, what is MP? It's good, but it's not priority at this point in time. Everybody's priority must be to make sure that the president goes and take over the leadership of Zambia and deliver the people of Zambia. Even if you have only 20 MPs in parliament, it's okay. What is important now is the presidency. People of UPND, stop being selfish. Akainde Hichilema, leadership of UPND, you must minimize. Try and start patronizing everybody. Yes. Pick up your call and call Calabar, Harry Calabar. Get him engaged. Give him parliament. Yes, I'm saying it because you don't need parliament. What you need is the presidency. Give him parliament. Pick up your phone, call Nevers Mumba. Give him parliament. Pick up your phone. Call Chishimba Kambwiri. Give him parliament. Work together. What is important this time is to get the presidency, not the parliament. It's better to lose all the parliamentarian seat and win the presidency. There is nothing you can do in parliament. You can't change anything. You are in parliament. PF is looting the country dry. You are in parliament. Talking in parliament, Edgar Lungu has destroyed the economy. Edgar Lungu himself is confused. He doesn't even know what to do. Edgar Lungu is saying that people are jeopardizing the commodity prices, the food prices. He doesn't know that he has destroyed the country. He doesn't know that dollar is now trading at 22 kwacha per dollar. When he took it, when it was mere quarter per dollar, he destroyed everything, and it's not aware that he has destroyed everything. He doesn't know that for you to import something from South Africa today, you will cry. He doesn't know that for you to import something from China today, you will cry, because dollar has climbed up, quarter has lost value. Edgar Lungu is not aware, and the people of UPND. You are in parliament. There is nothing that you are going to do when you have numbers in parliament until you get the presidential seat. So those of you that are UPND, UPND leaders, adjust yourself. Learn to accommodate people. Prepare to lose parliamentarian seats. Sacrifice some of them. Sacrifice to Harry Calabar. Sacrifice to Chishimba Kamburi. Sacrifice to Nefes Mumba. Anywhere you know that these guys are strong, that side, give them parliament. Let them contest. Support them. What is important is the presidency. When you get your presidency, you've gotten everything you want. Please, I am begging you. I am begging you. Take this my advice. Don't allow selfishness in this election. August is all about number. I'm telling you, even looking at the statistics that ECZ has released, I can assure you that PF has lost the election already. PF is already gone. They have lost the election already. But we still need numbers. So you PND people, adjust yourself a bit. Adjust yourself a bit. Learn to sacrifice seats. We don't need parliamentarian seats. Now, we need the presidency. We want somebody that will go and replace Edgar Lungu and change the course of everything in Zambia. I'm not going to waste your time. Coming to honeybee scandal. Many people have cried about honeybee. Many people have been yelling. Many people have been, honeybee. These days, if you see anything bee in Zambia, you run away. Because everything about honeybee is scandal. Because of honeybee in Zambia today, there are thousands of people that have been affected with HIV and AIDS. Because of honeybee today, there are thousands of pregnancies, unwanted pregnancies, that young girls are carrying today. Because of honeybee today, there are a lot of health complications. In fact, if I'm to say, I can say that honeybee in Zambia, they have committed genocide. And they are supposed to be answering questions in court right now or snoring in jail. But nothing has happened. But let me tell you the reason why nothing has happened. There was a time that I'm going to be telling you in part by part. The story is long, but let me give you a small one. Let me just give you a little thing that you have to know about honeybee. Honeybee is a company owned by Chilufya Chetalu. And Edgar Lungu is a beneficiary. Honeybee was not even registered on a working day. It was registered on a Saturday. And in Zambia, I've lived in Zambia for many, many years. I never saw Pakra or any registration company opening during the weekend. But Honeybee was registered on the weekend. Honeybee is a company that is owned by Chilufya Chetalu. And what they did is that they carried some Indian people and put them ahead and tell them to say, run this company for us. But behind is our company. Any contract that comes here, we supply, we collect our share, and we give you your share. Chilufya Chetalu is a corrupt fool. Chilufya Chetalu and Edgar Lungu are the most corrupt people in the world. They have killed the people of Zambia indirectly. And what happened? The woman, the permanent secretary that was sacked in the Ministry of Health is a girlfriend. She's sleeping with Chilufya Chetalu. She is the one that brings out the contract. Give to honeybee. Honeybee supply useless medication. Receive the money. Give to Chilufya Chetalu. Chilufya Chetalu gives to Edgar Lungu. That is the reason why, even if you bring Jesus Christ to Zambia today to persecute honeybee, nothing is going to happen. I am sorry for the wife of Chilufya Chetalu, because your husband has been cheating with you, with the permanent secretary that was sacked. The reason why that woman was sacked is to close investigation. Nothing is going to happen to that woman. That woman is not going to go to prison. The court case If at all it will go to court, we'll be dragging, dragging, hoping that they can win election next year and acquit her. She, nothing is going to be done to her because she's sleeping with Chilufya Chital. She's a disgrace to womanhood. You sleep with somebody's husband because of money. You are a fool. Money is going to kill you. That money that you have eaten is going to kill you. It's going to kill your children. You will never, never be successful in life. Your children are going to be prostitutes together with you and the Chilufya Chitalu. For exposing the life of people of Zambia to danger, killing the people of Zambia innocently, giving them S and STIs, your generation is going to suffer. All of you that are involved in this, Chilufya Chitalu, Edgar Lungu, and the permanent secretary that was fired, all of you, all your children are going to be useless. Olumpa Olumba, start killing your children one by one. Godfather, start eating your children one by one. You are cursed. All of you are cursed. All of you are cursed. Prostitute, a permanent secretary. That is why, that is how can, when you put your girlfriend, the current minister of health, said there is a lot of corruption in the Ministry of Health. Tell me the reason why there will not be corruption when Chilufya Chitalu has put his girlfriend is the one in charge. This is how you have useless Zambia. I miss President Sata. During the time of President Sata, such rubbish is not going to happen. Edgar Lungu is a weak man. It's a woman that is wearing trouser and is benefiting a lot. I want you to cut my finger. If that woman will ever go to prison, cut my head. She's not going anywhere. Somebody say, what about Chomba Kayoma? Chomba Kayoma has nothing to do with that. Don't be stupid. A young man like that is struggling to survive. Do you know how much $17 million is? $17 million. The people that have eaten that money is Chilufya Chitalu, Edgar Lungu, and that lady that they fired. The reason why they removed that lady is to blind the people of Zambia. She's not going to prison. Those of you that were jumping up the day Chilufya Chitalu was fired, I told you nothing is going to happen. He was not fired. The Edgar Lungu, I was there the day they were having a meeting to say, no, look, I'm going to do like this, I'm going to do like this to blind the people of Zambia. Edgar Lungu, you are a disgrace. You are a bloody disgrace to the people of Zambia. You are the worst president in the history of Zambia. What are you even doing there? Honey Bee is a den of prostitution. Honey Bee and Zamtel is the same. They are den of prostitution. That is what Ministry of Health. Den of prostitution. The owner of Honey Bee, Chilufya Chitalu, they just put some Indians in front to say, you pose as the owners of Honey Bee. The right owners of Honey Bee is Chilufya Chitalu and the girlfriend that has been fired. Nothing is going to happen to that woman. I swear upon Godfather, if that woman go to prison, then know that Edgar Indetlema will lose the election. Even if I've said it, Edgar Lungu is watching me. Top PF officials are watching me. The OP, Office of the President, the top securities in Zambia, they are watching me. I'm saying, if that woman go to prison, you know that I'm not a prophet. I feel sorry for the people of Zambia. I'm so sorry for you. But relax. Relax. Your time of liberation is this year. The Bible says in John chapter 10